my friends. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to my channel if you are new here. I am Martina Lily and today we have a very different video for my channel and this may not be for you and that is totally fine. If it is not, I will hopefully see you in the next one. But today we are going to do a Q&A. I asked you guys ages ago questions to celebrate like hitting 12k here on the channel and it just kind of slipped through the cracks. I got really busy and didn't film them. So I've got those questions to answer from Instagram and YouTube and then also some new ones that I asked you. And then I also got sent this Try Treats mystery snack box, which I'll chat to you about in a second. And I thought we would try the snacks together and answer the questions. Now I am sensitive to mouth noises and like eating noises myself, so I am going to try my absolute hardest to edit out or like put music over any mouth eating noises. So if you're looking for a, is it a mukbang? Is that mukbang? Is that how you, you know, the eating kind of YouTubers? That's not me. And I am going to try my best to minimize those sounds. So I apologize in advance for that, but I just thought this would be a bit of fun. And I asked you guys on Instagram if you want to see me try these snacks on video and you said yes. So here we are. Anyway, do the YouTube things, like, subscribe, all that jazz. And let's get into it. So this is trytreats.com. This is not sponsored in any way. They actually just sent this to me in PR. They reached out and was like, do you want to try this? And I was like, getting food in PR, this is, I've hit the lottery. Like, I love food. This was amazing to me. So it's like a monthly subscription box. I don't know if you guys can see that, where they send you snacks from a different country around the world, which again, that's freaking amazing. It comes with like a card with like all of the snacks that you're gonna get and then like you can keep track of which ones you like. It also has like a fact card about the country. So this month's mystery box was Mexico, which is very exciting because I've actually never tried Mexican snacks before. I've only been to Mexico like once, maybe twice with work, and I was only there very quickly, so I didn't really get to see much or do much. I absolutely love it. It looks so beautiful and I'm dying to go back to Mexico with my husband. So when I saw that it was like all Mexican treats, I was really excited. Also, I know a lot of you guys here in the community on my channel are from Mexico and I talk to quite a lot of you in my DMs and stuff. And so I thought that was pretty exciting to get to try some of your culture. I don't even know how much this is per month. Sorry, I think it's like $30 Australian a month off the top of my head. But I'll have the company link down below in case you're interested. And they did give me a discount code. I'm holding this up like you can read the thing. Which is Martina Lily, and it contains a 15% off your first box purchased. If that's an affiliate, I'll let you know. I don't know if it is off the top of my head. And like I said, this isn't sponsored, but I just actually thought this was gonna be so much fun. If companies wanna send me food for PR, I'm stoked, like stoked. I actually started filming this before and wasn't recording, fun fact. So I have tried this one. This is a Bubbaloo bar, and it is a chocolate covered marshmallow and strawberry jelly chocolate. So I tried a bite of this before, and if you are New Zealander or you know this, if you know what a buzz bar is, which is like essentially the same thing, but instead of the strawberry jelly, it's caramel. It tastes like a buzz bar, but instead of strawberry, instead of caramel, it has strawberry jelly. So it's not my all-time favorite treat because it is a little bit too sweet for me. The strawberry jelly is just like a little bit too sweet for me. I also have a decaf coffee in my Simply Blair mug. Shout out to Simply Blair and her merch. I have decaf because it is after work now and I don't need to be up all night bouncing around the house. My poor man would be like, oh my God. So the first question is from Julia YK. Thank you. And thank you so much if you have asked me a question. It blows my mind that you guys want to know anything more about me. And thank you so much if you have supported my channel in any way to get to this point. Like, again, anyone that wants to watch me, I'm like, really? Like, thank you. Because I'm just a chaotic lady trying to get through life. Okay, so the first question is, what YouTubers do you follow and who inspires you makeup and lifestyle? I follow probably all the same YouTubers a lot of makeup lovers follow, like Teresa Is Dead, obviously Simply Blair, Glam by Sam, Emily's Makeup Bag, Mariam A, who is a fellow community friend on the channel here, Angelica Nyquist, Heather Austin, Khaki Reviews Beauty, Sophia C's Beauty. I love her channel too. Tanya B. Wells, I love her channel. I follow pretty much like all of the beauty YouTubers that are like actual beauty YouTubers and not just giant influencers that say they're in the beauty community, but actually are not. No shade intended, but maybe a little. Anyway, and then I also follow, I'm a huge law nerd. So I love Emily D. Baker. I love LawTube. I love watching it because I always wanted to be a lawyer. And I think if I, so fun fact, I got diagnosed with ADHD last year and I'm 33 now. So I got diagnosed when I was 32. And so that's a long time to go undiagnosed with ADHD, let me tell you. And I think if I had been diagnosed earlier with ADHD, my life would be dramatically different. And, you know, which way, either or is fine because, you know, I'm also very happy with the life that I have now. But I always wanted to be a lawyer. And I wonder if I had been diagnosed earlier in life, if I would have become a lawyer because the meds would have helped me like focus. But anyway, so I love LawTube. So I follow like Emily D. Baker, Lauren Lumber, Lawyer You Know, and oh, Michelle Wong. I love watching her vlogs. I love watching Jessica Braun and Taylor Wynn. You know, all those kinds of ones. That's about it though. I'm a massive Bravo lover. I love Bravo. And so I also follow like Campire and Up and Adam and No Filter with Zach Peter and like all of those kinds of gossipy ones as well. I love them too. The second question was, now that your collection is becoming quite big, do you feel overwhelmed by the amount of makeup or do you feel satisfied and creative? And I thought this was a really awesome question because especially if you've been around my channel from pretty much the beginning, you will have seen my collection really has started to grow or is grown. And I actually don't feel overwhelmed. I'm probably at the tipping point, I think, though. I can feel myself, starting to get overwhelmed, but not necessarily I guess it is overwhelmed. It's the same thing because I feel like I have so much beautiful makeup. I want to use it all, but I also feel very satisfied and creative with my collection. Like I look at my collection and I can get so many video ideas or just like so many look ideas, and I just want to like dive in and play with every single product. Like I don't keep products that I don't like. If I know that I don't like something straight away, I pretty much move it out of the collection quickly. So because of that, the collection that I have, while being large, is a collection that I love and adore everything in. And every day I do my makeup, but every time I do my makeup I try and use like different products and stuff. So yeah, I definitely am at a point where I'm like slowing down my consumption, and like products have to be intriguing to me personally for me to want to pick them up at the moment. But I also just love and adore every single piece in my collection, so it's a little from column A and a little from column B, which is probably annoying. Sorry. Okay, let's try a dip, something else. I want to get this snack over and done with because I don't like spicy food, and when I showed this on my Instagram, you guys were like careful with the Tacos Fuegos. Is that what they're called? What are they called? Let me have a look. Yeah, Tacos Fuego by Barcelos. So it's a hot chili pepper and lime flavored tortilla chip. Extra spicy. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. You guys, I hate spicy food. Like I can't even stand pepper. We'll do it. We'll do it for science, okay? So it looks like this. If you haven't seen one, I'm sure you guys will love it. Oh god. Okay, that's not too bad. Does it grow even spicier? I mean, it's spicy now. I feel like it's getting spicier, but it's manageable for me. It's like a good spicy. This is a good spicy. What is this seasoning? Because this isn't so spicy that I'm like wanna die. Because you know how some people have spice and they can taste, like it enhances the flavor, whereas other people it's just like burning hot. I'm that person, but this isn't too bad. And I really like the lime. I think I could eat like maybe two of these at a time and I'd be okay, but I wouldn't be able to eat like a whole packet at a time. Okay, now it's really starting to burn in the back of my throat. Yeah. They're not as bad as I was expecting. And I kind of like them. And if I could handle more spicy food, I feel like I would really, really like them. But there's a burn and I can feel the burn. Okay, great. All right, this next one is from Duchess Marie. This is gonna be such a long video, so hopefully you guys are happy to chill and hang out with me. I was looking and I thought it was already 30 minutes and I was like, oh God. Hi Martina, if you could only purchase and use makeup from one brand, what would it be and why? I think NARS Cosmetics, because they're probably, and I know that seems surprising, but like, they're probably the only brand that I've tried that like has every category of product, and they're, each category has like a really good staple holy grail kind of product. So while it's not like Like, I love Natasha Denona eyeshadow palettes, for example, but I don't love her complexion products. I love Pat McGrath Labs eyeshadow palettes and complexion products, but she doesn't have like everything, you know, yet. Same with Lisa Eldridge. And I don't super love her foundation. Whereas like with NARS, I really like, say, the Climax palette. Like, I've got a couple of their palettes and I really like them, but I also love like the Light Reflecting Foundation, the Sheer Glow Foundation, the Laguna Cream Bronzer is my favorite. I love the Powder Bronzer. Like, I think NARS as a whole is like a really good staple brand that you can just rely on. And so definitely I think it would be NARS for sure. This is the Renita Croa by De La Rosa. So it is a sweet and crunchy Mexican chocolate known as the Little Frog Croak, from a popular brand. It has Rice Krispie bits in it. Oh, it's all cracked, so I can't fully show it. Apologies, but let's try some.
This is good. I really love it. Real good.
Next up, Chelsea and HA8032. I'm sorry if I butcher any of your names. You may have already answered this one in the past, but what is your job outside of YouTube and how do you incorporate your love of beauty into your everyday life? Vaguely, because I don't, you know, it's the internet and the internet be internetting. I am an operations leader for a corporate travel company, and I run Australia, New Zealand, the Australia and New Zealand division of it. And it is stressful and it is full on, but I've been doing it for a very, very long time. So it's also like, I know it like the back of my hand. And how do I incorporate my love of beauty into everyday life? I do my makeup every day. Well, I try to. Some days I don't get time to, but just sitting down and making time to do my makeup, I just love it. Or just coming in and like plain and swatching my makeup. I just love that. Like, I'm not, like, I definitely do my skincare and all that kind of stuff, but I'm not, and my nails, like, I've really gotten into nails, but like, I'm also not someone that's like a pamper kind of person. Like, don't get me wrong, I love going to a spa and I love other people pampering me, but like, I'm not gonna pamper myself at home. Making time every single day to do my makeup, it just, I always feel so much better and I just absolutely love it. It's the best time of the day for me. What was your most inspirational beauty moment this year? Could be a product release, brand release, beauty image, beauty moment, etc. That is a Maya Industrial 2.0 palette. I just love and adore that. The Natasha Denona I Need a Nude palette, the Natasha Denona Yucca palette, the new Glamonatrix Glimmering Shimmers, I think they're called that. They're amazing. I've got them on my, oh, by the way, this look will already be up on the channel. They're on my eyes at the moment. I don't know. There's been so many. I don't have a standout one, but I do think like the Isamaya Industrial palette really took my breath away, the 2.0. And then what do you think is the biggest difference in Australians' beauty style slash sensibility and North Americans? I mean, that's a little bit hard to answer because I think it depends on where you, I mean, guess it's the same in the US actually. I feel like it depends on where you live in Australia. So speaking from someone who's a Queenslander and mostly our weather is just like hot year round. Like even this winter, we barely got a winter, which was awesome because I hate winter, but, you know, a lot of the times, and like I live on the coast, so a lot of Australians that live on the coast will wear like, you know, that kind of very much the makeup that's in style now, like that almost no makeup makeup look or a very pulled back makeup look, a beachy makeup look, or like, you know, the, what was it, latte makeup? That was such a good representation is what I'm trying to say of Australians' makeup style, I think. But obviously within that, you still get your, you know, people that will go like full glam, kind of like me, or like people that will wear lashes, go clubbing, all that kind of stuff. But I would say on the most, at least from where I am, it's very laid back and barely there and natural. Whereas like when I went to Northern, or when I go to America, the thing that I love about America is you can really just be whoever the hell you want most of the time, at least the cities that I went to. And I would say like LA and Vegas and stuff, you know, the girls there that I notice like in the shops and stuff, they get so glam, which I love, but also false lashes. Like I have never seen false lashes like I have seen in North America. It's insane. Like you'll love your lashes. Like I couldn't even lift my eyes, I think, if I wore those lashes. But yeah, I think Australians are a lot more pared back, at least from the knowledge that, well, at least from like the Australians that I have incurred versus the Americans when I've visited America. I love both. I think just do you. This is from Tanya RF6KL. Have you ever done or been interested in doing someone else's makeup? Maybe for like 2 seconds and then no. Because like, okay, maybe if I could be, say, like Lisa Eldridge, right? Or like Makeup by Mario. But the reality of that, especially as someone who lives in Australia is and my age right now and wanting to uproot my life and stuff, like slim to none, right? And then you think about like the other side of that is like bridal makeup and stuff like that. And I just do not want to deal with brides. Like, what a nightmare. So yeah, no, I just like doing it on myself. I like testing formulas and playing with it on myself and swatching it and creating content. Like, that's what I love. I love filming the videos and stuff. Who would be fun to co-host a video with? Anyone from your real life or other YouTubers or celebrities? Oh gosh, I have so many people that like come to mind instantly. My best friend Mon, she is such a personality. Like, I'm a massive introvert, like cat type personality, and she's like a massive extrovert, like dog type personality. And so she is just such a whole other level of personality. So like if we co-hosted something, that would be so much fun. Other YouTubers like Simply Blair would be awesome. But also even just like, I would love to be able to talk to like Teresa Is Dead or something, cause she just cracks me up. And then a celebrity, oh gosh, I don't know, Taylor Swift. Can I say Taylor Swift? I love that. Or like, I would love to meet Eminem. Random, I know. If you could go to Sephora with any beauty guru, who would you pick? Simply Blair. That would be so much fun. We could go shopping and it would be the best. The best time. Let's try another snack. What is this? This is a very small one. Pulparindo with real fruit. So this is, oh gosh, chili and tamarind flavored bar. It's spicy, one of a kind. Oh gosh, okay. Spicy? Why is everything spicy? I'm just gonna add a small amount. Oh no, I don't like that. It tastes weird. Sorry, I don't mean to offend anyone if I don't like anything, but... Oh, it tastes weird and then it has a kick to it afterwards. No. No, the Pulparindo is a no. This one's from Elijah McKinnon. If you were going to pick one brand to do a full face of makeup for the rest of your life, what brand would it be and what products would you choose? So I already answered that, I think, previously. So that was NARS and their entire line. So Sean Dixon 2390, there are several amazing indie brand eyeshadows I've recently tried. What are some indie brands you'd like to look into to expand your collection? So I previously would have actually said Blend Bunny being one of them, but they just recently came to Australia and I picked up the All Done Up palette and I have used it off camera and I really, really like it. Like it's absolutely beautiful. But I think the only other indie brand that I'm aware of that I desperately would like to get my hands on some of their shadows is Divina Cosmetics. So one day I will. I've just got so much eyeshadow that I'm like trying to hold myself back a little bit, but I definitely can see myself trying Divina next as an indie brand. Egreaves 79, congrats, thank you so much. What is your normal makeup routine like? Literally what you guys see on YouTube. Yeah, literally. Like, I worked today. This is what I'm wearing. Like, what you guys see on YouTube is exactly what my makeup looks like. Sometimes my eyeshadow might be a little bit more glam, but even then, half the time I'm doing it before work, the filming. So yeah, no, it's literally, especially my base routine, that is exactly what I do every single day without fail. It might look like, it's a lot of steps, don't get me wrong, and it might look like a lot of makeup, but I use very thin layers that like build on each other. And so I personally find it still looks quite natural. And it's just a tried and true way that I've done it, but I know my makeup will last all day with my skin type and everything and just how I like to look. So yeah, it really is what you guys see on YouTube. Because half the time I'm filming me doing my makeup every day for YouTube, you know? Lisa Nutini 5183, what were your first makeup items you ever wore? Mine were blue eyeshadow, a brown crayon liner and mascara novel. Yeah, I mean, that was probably the 90s, right? My mum loves blue eyeshadow, bless her little heart. Yeah, probably pretty close to you, to be fair. I didn't do the eyeshadow. I wasn't allowed. My parents were really strict with makeup. I wasn't really allowed to wear makeup until I was like 16, 17, maybe even later than that. But I remember like the very first product I had was like a clear mascara and I felt so clever because I was like, my parents don't know that I'm wearing this. Like, ha ha ha. But yeah, I was definitely like, you know, makeup wasn't what it was in my teens. I was like a teenager in the early 2000s, or like in the 2000s, I should say. And so yeah, black eyeliner was all the rage, like black smudged eyeliner. I used to just like rim my eyes with it. And then I would wear pretty much no foundation and just mascara, and that's it. Like, I didn't start wearing blush, I think, until I was like 18, maybe. Yeah, probably 18. This one's from RL Maverick. Hi Martina, what do you Aussies think of Napoleon Purdis, the brand? I feel like I never hear about them. Are they considered high end? Have you ever tried their makeup? No, I actually haven't. They've just never interested me, truly. I don't know why. I can't, they did have like, they used to have like a big heyday, but the brand just never appealed to me. I don't know. I don't think they are high. They used to be high end, but now I think they're considered more drugstore-ish because they're in our drugstore. They're in Priceline, which is drugstore for us. So yeah, but no, I really haven't tried anything. Have you guys, like any Australians that are watching, if you've tried the brand, let us know in the comments, because I really haven't. This one's from Chantel Mija 8491. What is your favorite lipstick in the category pinks, reds, and corals? Love your channel. You're a great answer. Oh, thank you so much. Like, you guys send me the nicest, like, comments and sentiments, and it just, you have no idea how much you guys make my day. Like, you just have no idea. Like, you just have no idea what you do for me. So thank you. Favorite lipsticks. Red is Strawberry Shock from Lisa Eldridge. I only own one coral lipstick, and it is Je Ne Sais Quoi from Lisa Eldridge. And I don't have a favorite like hot pink yet. I am searching for that though, so if you know one, let me know. But my favorite pink in general would be Rose Incense from Hermes, for sure. Emily's makeup bag. Hello, Emily. Do you see YouTube as your full-time job anytime soon or ever? I mean, I dream for it to be like my full-time job. I would love nothing more than that. I get so much joy out of my channel and you guys that it would be such an honor to like be able to do this full time. But the reality is, no, it's not gonna happen anytime soon. I think being in Australia as well, it's a lot harder for me to like get off the ground, and like I definitely don't have the same earning opportunities and stuff like that, which is fine. I'm not complaining, it's just a reality. But where I'm at right now, like, definitely not looking at anytime soon. Melina M Makeup. Hi Melina. What is your go-to AM PM skincare routine? What do you swear by or holy grails for your skin/skin type? I know a lot of makeup questions, but I get curious about skincare too. Yeah, I am not an expert at skincare, but Allies of Skin, you guys, I recently did like my current beauty favorites, and I talked about Allies of Skin in it. I hands down swear it has transformed my skin. It has transformed my skin. So Allies of Skin, I still use the Neon Sachuride spray as like my toner. So I use that. And then I use the Allies of Skin eye cream. And then in the morning, I just put on the peptide moisturizer and then sunscreen or whatever. I use the Purito sunscreen, sorry. And then in the evening, I will put on like same first two steps, and then I put a pump of the Summer Fridays Oasis Hydration Serum thing, and then a pump of the Blemish Nightly Face Mask from Allies of Skin. I use that every day and I swear by it. And then every now and then I'll use the TLC like glycolic serum from Drunk Elephant as like a kind of deeper exfoliation. But very rarely, like once a week, if that, because my skin just is really sensitive. It doesn't like anything too aggressive. And then I use the Allies of Skin cleanser with the Tatcha rice polish like every morning. And then at night I just use the Allies of Skin cleanser. And then my cleansing oil to remove makeup at the moment is the Florasis one, which I really like. So yeah, I love Allies of Skin though. It has really transformed the game for me. It truly has. Okay, let's try another one. This doesn't look spicy. So this one is a Carlos V chocolate by Nestle, a staple chocolate bar in Mexico since the 70s. It has a rich smell and a unique powdery taste. And you will better understand why Mexicans think this is the number one chocolate. So this is it right here. Okay. So while I'm opening this, let's do another one. Sadaf Khan 95. Congratulations. Thank you so much. How did you start your YouTube channel? What or who was your main inspiration, and how do you incorporate it in your daily life? Okay. So this is what it looks like. It's probably a little bit melted. I like it. I like it. I started YouTube because, okay, so long story short, I have talked about this in other Q&As. I'll link my other Q&As down below. I've always been interested in makeup and beauty and everything, but when I was younger, traveling definitely took over, like, first. And then when I was like 25 or around that age, I came off the pill and I got acne for the first time. I was one of those blessed teenagers that literally never even had a pimple. And then I got bad skin coming off the pill and I was like, I need to learn how to put foundation on and stuff. Like I'd had makeup and I'd had foundation and stuff, but like I'd only used the Bare Minerals powder foundation for like years at that point. And I needed more coverage and stuff. And also I was kind of like, I'm just interested, like what's going on in the beauty space kind of thing. And so I watched Kristen Dominique, how to apply liquid foundation video. And then I watched another of her video and another and another. And then this is back in like 2015 when like these guys are just getting started out, right? Like I remember they were living in one bedroom apartments in LA. And then I watched Laura Lee and then I watched Nicole Concilio. And then I think, who else did I watch? Like Carly Bible. Oddly, I never really got onto Jaclyn Hill. I don't know if she was posting them, but yeah, I don't really remember ever watching many of her videos. I watched a lot of like Laura Lee and like Desi Perkins, Katie, all them. I just started like falling more and more in love with it and then buying more and more makeup. And it's funny because I had this like drawer of makeup. Like it was just a drawer, like a small bathroom drawer. And I was like, oh my gosh, I have so much makeup. Like, what am I going to do with it? And I've always wanted to be creative. I've always wanted to work for like a magazine or be an actress or like something in that field. And I was just kind of like, this could be a way for me to, I guess, do that, but on my own terms kind of thing. And like, you know, makeup Instagram was slowly becoming a thing, or was a big thing back then and stuff. So I just started an Instagram first and then did that for ages. And then, you know, years down the track, I'm a perfectionist. It took me a really long time to just bite the bullet and put a YouTube video up because I'm such a freaking perfectionist. It really held me back, but it was something that I always wanted to do. And then as soon as I started, I uploaded my first one and I just fell in love. And I did have a year break in between uploading my first ones and like starting again because work just got too busy for me. And then COVID hit and I had time again. And it's just like, the more I post, the more I love, the more videos I create, the more I love it. Yeah, I just absolutely love it. It just brings so much joy and it's such a creative outlet for me. And to like, I don't really have any makeup lovers in my everyday life. So to meet like-minded makeup lovers, it's the best thing, truly. This video is gonna be so freaking long, but hopefully you like it. Okay, so makeup 561, do you know how wonderful you are? No, and thank you. Thank you so much, truly. 2, has any brand reached out to you and asked anything untoward, like review this, but only give us positive reviews if you want more products? No, I genuinely haven't had that. I get the brands that reach out and are like, will you do a sponsored video for this, for free product? In which case I'm like, no, unless for some reason it's a product that I really, really want. But I'm like, no, you know what? Like, it takes a good 8 hours. Every YouTube video is about 8 hours to get up, 6 to 8 hours, depending on the length. And so I'm like, I need to value my time. Like, the product doesn't pay my bills, but also, I mean, YouTube isn't paying my bills, to be frank. It's not going to. But I'm like, if you want your product sponsored, you need to pay for my time to create that content. You know what I mean? So I get brands that do that. But I haven't had anyone be like, can you like only give us a positive review? Because to be honest with you, like, I wouldn't take it if I had to do that. It's always going to be genuine. And I also don't take sponsorships if I haven't tried and tested the product first, because I can't do something that I don't feel connected to, that I don't want to do. And also I'm kind of picky with my sponsorships as well. I am very picky with my sponsorships because I have this really weird thing where right now I do this because I love it and I want to do it and it's joyful and it's all on my own terms. And then as soon as I take a sponsorship, I kind of get funny about it because it's like all of a sudden I have to do that. Like I have to, and it's become like a real job and I hate that. And I get real like rebellious against it. So I only take sponsorships that I'm like truly passionate about, because otherwise it's like, it's just a nightmare for me to even get it done. Number 3, what brand would you love to collab with? Is it PMG? No, I think the number one brand that I would love to collab with right now would be Lisa Eldridge. I just love and adore her so much. And also Pat McGrath Labs for sure. They would be my top 2, 100%. Which 2 creators would you suggest we follow? Oh, that's a great question. Simply Blair, for sure. Mariam A, if you don't already, I'll have her link down below. And then also Eva Hansen. I'm pretty sure that's her tag on YouTube. Let me check. Dear Eva Hansen is her YouTube name. Danielle Zadora 7637. If you could collab with any one brand, who would it be? Okay, I've answered that. Lisa and Pat. What is your hair care routine now? Do you still wear alternative hair? And that's from Nalie 9018. I did recently update an updated... That didn't make sense. I did recently upload an updated hair video on my channel. So I'm going to link that in the description box for you. I recommend checking that one out to see what my hair routine is now. Long story short, I do still wear alternative hair, but I really have nowhere near as much. I'm actually just lazy, to be completely honest with you. I still love and adore my wigs, but I chopped all my hair off up to here recently, and it really made such a difference in like my hair's thickness and health and everything. And so I haven't really felt the need or the want to wear it as much, but I definitely still do. Emily's makeup bag again. Hello. How's married life? Married life is amazing. I love my husband that much. It's insane. You know, we've been together 9 years though. So we've only been married for just over a year, but like we've been together 9 years. So, you know what you're getting into. And I just, he's my best friend. I just love him. Danielle Zadora 7637. What made you want to do YouTube? I think I already answered that question, right? So there you go. All right, let's move on to these newer questions, but let's also try another snack. Let's try these. These are intriguing to me. So these are the Pinatera Nuts by Manzella. So Japanese style peanuts made by the most prominent creator of Japanese style nuts in Mexico. What's a Japanese style nut? So that's what they look like. Are these spicy too? Oh, they just went everywhere. Okay. So it kind of looks like this. Let's see. It's a peanut, and mainly you can just taste the peanut, but it also has that like crunch to it. And I like the crunch. I'm all about the crunch. Nice. All right. Japanese style peanuts. What are they called? Pinatera Nuts by Manzella. Big win. Big win. The Liz Fizz one. If you could only pick one eyeshadow brand to wear or buy for the rest of your life, which do you pick? Oh, that's mean. I think Natasha Denona. And I know you're surprised that I'm not saying Pat, but going off of the current trajectory of how I'm feeling about Natasha Denona versus Pat McGrath Labs, the brand itself, not the people, I'm loving what Natasha is bringing to the table. So let's go Natasha Denona. Also, what hobbies do you have outside of makeup? I'm a makeup obsessed, but also love knitting and cooking. That's awesome. They're awesome hobbies. My nana tried to teach me to knit, and then after like 3 days was like, absolutely not. You are useless at this. And I was like, that's fair. Hobbies. I don't really have time to have hobbies outside of makeup because I have a full-time job, and then YouTube is also pretty much a full-time job, and then just trying to fit in time with family, friends and husbands and all that kind of stuff, you know, doesn't leave a lot of time for hobbies. But travel is a big one. Like, I love traveling so much. I love seeing the world. I don't know, I sound really boring. I love watching movies and TV shows and all that kind of stuff. I love reading books. I love like sci-fi vampire books. Like J.R. Ward is a favorite author of mine. Who else? No one else is coming to mind. I'm so sorry. But yeah, honestly, I'm either working, doing YouTube stuff, or trying to have a social life in between that, or sleeping. Jessark 4719. I think it would be interesting to hear about your schedule and how you manage filming in another position. The biggest thing is I work from home. If I didn't work from home, I don't think I would be able to continue doing YouTube. And if I did, I think I would only be able to do it maybe like get one or two videos up, if that, a week. Working from home allows me to have my channel for sure. But I am also like an introvert, and I don't, like, I love socializing and stuff, but I'm also not a partier and stuff like that. That's tiring to me. Like, I like one-on-one quality time with my friends, and that's about it. But even then, it's like, I enjoy my own company or just being at home with my cats and my husband. So yeah. Anyway, I usually get up between 4 or 5 a.m. I'm an early bird for sure. I just genuinely wake up then. So I get up between 4 and 5 a.m. and then I either get up straight away and either, usually depending on the day and what I've got on, I'll either get up and edit a video or film and then start work, or I will go to the gym and then start work, or also sometimes, like today, for example, I started work at 5 a.m. and then when that finished in the afternoon, now I'm filming. So it really depends on the day and my energy and stuff, because I do have chronic illnesses. I have endometriosis and stuff, and that comes with, what comes with that is chronic fatigue. So I just kind of manage my day based around my energy levels. And also, I'm quite mercurial with, like, I hate routine, but I also need routine, but I also hate routine. So I need to switch up my routine quite a lot for my sanity's sake. On the weekends, for example, like as soon as I wake up on a weekend, pretty much until like 6 o'clock at night, I'll just be doing YouTube and social media stuff. And then, you know, we might go to dinner or the movies or something like that. But pretty much both days on the weekend, I'm doing like makeup. And then before work, most days, or after work, I'll be doing it. So yeah, I really don't have any downtime. I don't have much downtime anyway. But I'm not complaining. Like, this is my hobby. This is my fun. Like, I find this fun. If I didn't, I wouldn't do it, you know? Let's try another snack. Oh, I really want to try these. So these are the Chocoritas, because this sounds like my jam. So these are small candies that are mint and chocolate flavor. And I love a mint, like, mint chocolate. So this is what they look like. Ooh. God, this video is going to be like an hour long. I hope you guys are having fun. Yep, they're exactly what I... Yeah, if you're a Kiwi, Snifters, remember Snifters? That's what these are like, kind of, but without the hard insert. Or if you've ever had a Mentos, like a peppermint Mentos, but with chocolate. I really like these. These are really good. Adriana Coppola, I'd be interested to get your thoughts on balancing a love of makeup and getting joy from applying it every day with the overconsumption and constant new launches that we're seeing from the beauty industry now. It's such a difficult circle to square. So I would love to hear your thoughts. Oh my gosh. Yeah. I feel that. I'm like, I find this a challenge because I am definitely like one of the things, and I don't mean to like keep bringing up my ADHD, but like, because I've only been recently diagnosed, I'm learning so much about myself because of my ADHD. And one of the things that is obviously, if you have it, is like you're constantly chasing a dopamine hit. So I'm constantly, and like, I don't smoke, I don't drink, I don't do drugs. So where I kind of get my dopamine hit is either food or shopping for me. And so I definitely need to take a step back when I'm purchasing things and going, am I chasing dopamine or am I like genuinely wanting this? Because I can get into that. So there's that side of things for me. Then there's also the like just genuine love of wanting to try every single makeup product known to man, because I'm genuinely interested in all these formulas and stuff. And then there's also the balance of like wanting to bring in new makeup to do reviews and stuff for you guys on YouTube. And then also the balance of genuinely just wanting to keep my collection a little bit smaller or like medium-ish, because I want to be able to use and love everything that I have. Like I look at, and this is no hate or shade towards this person because I think they are wonderful at what they do, but I look at Morgan Turner's collection and like that's too big for me. Like her collection overwhelms me. And I don't want to have a collection that big. I really like all my makeup pretty much gets housed in like my chest of drawers here behind me. And I like that. Like that's very manageable for me. I feel the pressure because when I see like channels really growing and growing quite quickly and stuff, it's because like a lot of the time they'll do like all new makeup releases and stuff like that. Like as much as people don't necessarily want to see the new all the time, it's what gets the traction in the algorithm. And like, obviously I do want to grow my channel. So, and also just try the new makeup. So there is that side of it. And I find it quite challenging, but also I don't get a lot of joy out of doing a lot of reviews. I like to do just get ready with me's, which are the most uninspiring, like unoriginal idea, but I just love doing a get ready with me. And so I think for me, it's coming to a point now where I'm like, okay, the product needs to bring me joy in some way, shape or form, will be interesting to me in some way, shape or form for me to purchase it. Because within my collection, I have all the colors, especially with eyeshadow palettes, I have all those colors and stuff. So it needs to now be something like, I haven't tried that formula, I'd like to try the formula, that sounds intriguing to me. Or that color story is really unique or beautiful, and I really would just love to have that in my collection, versus just feeling the pressure to get every single release, especially if you don't have like a channel, for example, right? And you're not rushing to get like a review up for views or whatever. Like, take a beat and wait a couple of weeks, because chances are, because like the thing that drives me wild is like, by the time, like after a week or two, the product is now old. Like, for example, I've put them away already, but I got the new like Chanel 4 blushes, right? Like, these only just got released, but there's so many reviews up on YouTube already for them that by the time I talk about them, they're old. And it's like no one even cares anymore kind of thing. And so if you wait those couple of weeks and wait for the product to get old and no one really cares anymore, even though I don't feel that way, like I don't care how old the product is. I buy my products based off of what interests me, not the release so much. But like by that point, if you still really want it and you still really think about it, like a month or two down the track, then it's probably something that you really do genuinely want to try in your collection. But if it's something that like goes away with the hype and the new release and like the videos, and then you don't even think about it anymore, then it's probably something that you didn't want in the first place or need in the first place. But it can be tough, right? Like, cause you see all these YouTubers like buying all this makeup and you're like, oh, that's beautiful, I probably want it. And like, I'm guilty of that. I'm not saying I'm any better than anyone. I buy a lot of new makeup and it's hard like to not get caught up in it. I don't think I helped in any way. I think I just rambled probably for 5 minutes and made this video longer. Sorry. Tiffany Weaver, would you rather give up your Pat eyeshadow collection or your Natasha Denona eyeshadow collection? My Pat. I'd rather give my Pat, because honestly, up until like Divine Rose 2 and Moonlit Seduction, the rest of it all kind of looks the same, if I'm honest. It's all bloody pink, isn't it? And the Natasha Denona eyeshadow collection, every single palette is very different. So yeah, I know. ID9472, what products in your collection, whatever price point, stand out as feeling the most luxe in regards to performance? Basically like a joy to work with and use. Great question. The Chanel Water Fresh Tint, hands down. I just absolutely love and adore that freaking product, truly. Gosh, so much. Like a Tom Ford eyeshadow quad, like my Pat McGrath Labs shadows, my Natasha Denona shadows, anything from Lisa Eldridge. Like, I love the Gucci highlighter. Anything from Victoria Beckham. I feel like I'm not answering that question well, but yeah, they're the ones like that really stand out instantly. There's some I'm probably missing, but instantly I think of those. BQ3668, what brought on your love of makeup? Was it a family member, friends, YouTuber, celebrity? And what makeup item was the gateway into your love of makeup? Was it lipstick or eyeshadow? Also, what other interests do you have outside of makeup? So I touched on the other interests outside of makeup, none, apart from travel. I've also touched on this quite a bit, like my love of makeup. It was just always there. My mum used to always take me shopping and she would go to like the Dior counter in Maya, because back then the drugstore makeup was horrible. And she would get her makeup done and pick out all her makeup, and I just always loved it so much. I still have like brushes and stuff that I got from Dior from when I was like 15. I just absolutely loved it. My gateway into my love of it was 100% foundation. I've always been obsessed with foundation and concealer. Always. It was definitely that, even over eyeshadow. Like, I just have always loved foundation and concealer and makeup brushes. Actually, I would even say makeup brushes more so than anything else. I don't know what it is about makeup brushes, but I am obsessed. Let's try this. This is a Focadin. So, a classic Mexican candy favorite, combination of crispy thin peanut wafers. Ooh, that sounds good. With delicious creamy chocolate. I like a peanut wafer. Okay, let's try it. Ash92, 1, if you wore bold colored lipsticks, AKA out of your comfort zone other than red, what are the top colors? Pink. Pink and a dark, like a vampy purple, a dark brown. Number 2, if you had to go extremely minimalist with your makeup collection, what would that collection look like? I'm talking one category, one product per category. That's me. This is freaking good. Oh my God, I love this. I love anything peanut covered in chocolate, and then you add the wafer. All right, primer, Chanel Water Fresh Tint. Oh, foundation, NARS Light Reflecting. Or the KVD Good Apples. Let's just go NARS Light Reflecting for quick sake. Concealer, the Urban Decay Quickie Concealer. Color corrector would be the Sigma Color Corrector. Cream bronzer would be the NARS Laguna Cream Bronzer. powder would be the Laura Mercier blurring powder. Bronzer would be probably the Pat McGrath Labs bronzer. Cream highlight would be Lisa Eldridge, just because I love her. Powder highlight would be the Hermes powder highlight, because I'm bougie. Cream blush would be probably the Rare Beauty liquid blushes for sure. And then powder blush would probably be, the Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk blushes. Setting spray would be Charlotte Tilbury. Mascara would be Victoria Beckham, the normal one, not the new one, Future Lash. Victoria Beckham eyeliners. Do not ask me what eyeshadow palette. I'm not answering. I don't know. Lip liner would be maybe Pat McGrath Labs contour. Lipstick would be Lisa Eldridge Let Me Pray. That's enough. Okay, I can't do any more than that. Hilda Alvarez 4702. Hi, Hilda. What do you think is the most overpriced makeup brand? Controversial, but Charlotte Tilbury. I said what I said. Also, Hilda, what is the most expensive product you've spent money on? Is it worth it? That's a great question. I have to have a look. Outside of a Pat McGrath Labs mothership, because that's the most expensive, because I think that's like $200 and something, it would be this, the Christian Louboutin powder. And it's because you have to buy the compact and then the powder. So like you have to buy them separately. And like, I think all up, it comes to like $180 or $190. I know I'm ridiculous, but I loved the packaging. Because I loved the packaging, yeah, it was worth it. Like I regret nothing, but is the product itself inside here worth it? No, nothing's going to be like, no. It's pretty good though. Don't get me wrong. Like it is lovely. It's a great product. But this product itself is like $80, I think, which for a luxury powder is actually not bad, but it's the fact that the case I think was like $90 or $100 Australian. And that's what made the product so expensive. But I mean, I regret nothing. The packaging's awesome. If you ask me. Tina Wheatman, I think 7124. Can we hear about your Bali trip, please? I'm currently holidaying in Bali. Well, congratulations, because Bali is the best. Bali is amazing. I love Bali. Honestly, my Bali trip was really, like, there's nothing to talk about, really, because we just stayed at the Mulia in Nusa Dua, which is our favorite resort in the entire world, and it is amazing, and I highly recommend staying at the Mulia. It is impeccable. But we were there for a week, and because I've been to Bali, like, 10 times between holidays and work, and Shane has been like 6 or 7 times as well. So we've done all of the sightseeing, all of the tourist stuff and everything. We purely just wanted to go to relax and like recharge. So we literally left the resort like once to do like a brief amount of shopping and a massage, and that was it. So I don't really have anything to say other than that it was amazing, because all we did was like eat, sleep, sit by the pool and get pampered at the spa and walk along the beach. And that was my Bali trip. But Bali is incredible. Balinese people are the kindest, most beautiful people in the entire world. I absolutely adore them. I absolutely adore Bali. I could totally live there. I love everything about it. It's such a beautiful place, truly. If you get a chance to go there, I highly recommend it. Coffee Cotton, how did you get approval from work to have a job outside of your main work? So, I mean, I don't need permission. I don't know if that's a thing. Like, is that a thing in America or something, or in other countries? And I don't even know if that's a thing in Australia. I don't need permission, as long as it doesn't impact my job in any way. And it's not like I'm competing. Like, that's in travel, this is makeup. So it's not like I'm in competition with them. But yeah, I don't need approval. What do you love most about your husband and your parents? The thing I love most about my husband is every single thing. His sense of humor. And how kind he is and how he allows me to be me, just proper me. And my parents, my mum is the best mum in the entire world. Sorry if you think you've got the best mum, mine's better. She's always put us kids first. She's so kind and caring, and she'd give you the shirt off her back. And she's shown me what it's like to be a resilient, strong woman. And my dad has shown me and taught me to be independent and march to the beat of my own drum. And I love that. Janice Morales 6240. I work from home and I think you said you did too. How do you encourage yourself to actually get ready for remote work? I find it hard to get up and do my makeup just to stay home. Yeah, I get that. I totally get that. I think for me, the difference is that I love it so much. Like it's such a almost like meditative, like it's the thing that I want to do every day. Is like, I don't so much, and I know this might sound a little bit weird, but I don't so much love wearing the makeup as I do just like putting on the makeup. It's like when I bake, I love the process of baking, but then as soon as it's baked, I don't even want to eat the product. I'm like, okay, I'm done with this now. For me, I just love it. It's like my favorite time of the day. So it's not hard to like to motivate myself because I want to do it. So that's a terrible answer for you. I'm so sorry. But I just find as well, like on the days where I don't, like I just don't feel as motivated and like energetic. I find like when I get up and like go to the gym or like just get up and like have a shower and get myself ready and get dressed and everything, I feel a lot more like energetic and almost like I've gone to the office. So yeah. That I find that helps a lot. All right, I think we should wrap this up, don't you? Because that was ridiculously long. Apologies, but hopefully you had a fun time with me. Thank you so much if you sent me a question. I love answering them. And again, it just blows my mind that you guys want to know anything more about me. I hope that my answers were okay. Thank you if you are watching till this point, because my God, I think this would have been the longest video I've ever uploaded. But hopefully you enjoyed it and had some fun with me and had fun hanging out. Let me know if you want to do more videos like this. Like I could get you guys around the world to like send me snacks, or like, you know, I could go to an international thing and get other snacks and we can try them and hang out and chat like this. I feel like it would be more fun on a live stream. So next time I do this, let me know if you would be interested in doing something like this on a live stream where we can just like hang out and actually chat. And yeah. Okay. Let me know your thoughts. I hope you had a good time. Sorry for the long video. Hopefully you have fun. Okay. Bye.